Grace and peace, everybody. Welcome to Change Bible Study. My name is Chris Bailey, and we're taking a look at the parable of the talents in this series in Matthew chapter 25. And we're really going to focus not so much on the talents, not even on the servants, but really with the idea to try and understand the master, the Lord. How does God think about us as his children and his thoughts towards us? That's the focus. Now, if you're going to be blessed by this, we're grateful. And if you are, subscribe to the channel and even share this with someone else and visit us at changeministry.org for a whole lot more. So let's get into it. But before we get into it, let's pray. Father, we ask now in the name of Jesus that you'd speak to our hearts and reveal your heart to us through this parable. Amen. In Matthew 25, I'm just going to summarize it quickly here in verses 15 to 18. It says, "And unto one he gave five talents, to another two, and to another one, to every man according to his several ability, and straightway took his journey. Then he that had received the five talents went and traded with the same, and made them five other talents. And likewise, he that received two, he gained other two. But he that had received one went and digged in the earth and hid his Lord's journey." Now remember up in verse 14, it says, the kingdom of heaven is like, and really not so much just the kingdom of heaven, but the king of heaven is like, not just giving these talents, but now look at verse 19. It says, "After a long time, the Lord of those servants cometh and reckoneth with them." So the kingdom of heaven, i.e. the king of heaven, is like this master who gives his servants these talents. And after a long time comes a day of reckoning. I know you've probably heard that term, the idea of the day of reckoning. In the Old Testament, the prophets usually referred to it as the day of the Lord. And now prophetically, we look to it as the coming of Christ, the second coming. It's good to know that the space, the gap between the giving of the gift and the day of reckoning in this parable, it's a long time. He is wanting us to be ready. Therefore, he gives us the gift of time, the gift of life. And this is not unique to this parable. If you go back, look at Matthew chapter 25, or rather 24, in this parable where it talks about the Lord and his servants. Verse 48, it says, "But and if that evil servant shall say in his heart, my Lord delayeth his coming." In this parable, what does the Lord do? Gives an assignment, gives a task, and then what? Gives time. But unfortunately, the wicked servant took that time for granted. Not only in this parable, look at another one. In the parable of the 10 virgins, where you have the five wise who kept their oil and the five foolish who neglected the oil, the presence of the Spirit of God. Look at what it says in verse 5. In that space, it says, "While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and they all slept." The difference was who had the oil. But in this parable, they slept because the Lord tarried, delaying, tarrying after a long time. This is a language of someone who wants us to be ready. A God who is giving us space to be prepared, not to prepare ourselves, but to be prepared by him. That's the gift of every day. Look at these verses back in Ezekiel chapter 12. In Ezekiel chapter 12, looking at verse number 22. Here you have the prophet, one of those who use that term of the day of the Lord. But here in Ezekiel chapter 12, look at verse 27. It says here, "Son of man, behold, they of the house of Israel say, the vision that he seeth is for many days to come. And he prophesied of the times that are far off." See, a wicked heart looks at that and takes it for granted. And not only do they take it for granted, go forward and look at Ecclesiastes. In Ecclesiastes chapter 8, the wicked see this time and they say in verse 11, Ecclesiastes, "Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily. Therefore, the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil." There's a consistency in the Lord's attitude to the righteous and the wicked. He gives them time. The wicked have a consistency in their response. They take that time for granted. Let's look at verse 11 of now Ecclesiastes as the other side of the same coin. Rather than taking this time for granted, the righteous, those who know they are loved by God, those who know that they have a heavenly Father who wants them to be prepared, not caught off guard. Let's look at this time as an act of grace. This is a space of love. This is a gap of grace to allow us to be prepared to be with him forever. That's the encouragement we want to leave with us today. You know, when you read this and see the other side of the same coin, now you can look at every tick of every second as an act of love, giving us the opportunity to fully embrace and to be fully sealed by the love of God. When I think about the seal of God now, I think about his arm, not just one arm, not just the other arm, but now both of his arms embracing us in his love. That's what he's waiting to do. Let him hug you. Let him love you. But in order to do that, you got to let him lead you. And look at this time as probation of a promise that he's coming soon, but he's not going to come any sooner than his children will allow him to make them ready. That's a promise. That's a blessing. Thank you, Jesus, for time. So let's live it to the fullest. If you've been blessed, please subscribe to this channel, like the video, share it. But remember, above all, believe it.